Good morning, Summerswood, and welcome to our Monday Assembly. Last week I mentioned that our theme for the year was rainbow. Can you remember what the letter R stood for? I hope you can. This week's Assembly, I'm going to be reading you a book because that R stood for reading. I hope you enjoy this story and perhaps we'll have a few questions to answer at the end. The Wolf Who Wouldn't Go to School. There was a wolf called Wilson who couldn't count to 10. He wouldn't learn to write his name. He never used a pen. He didn't know his ABCs. He couldn't paint or cook. He wouldn't learn his 2 plus 2s. He never read a book. "Time for school," his father cried. "You pesky little pup." "But school is boring," Winston whined, and he turned the telly up. One morning, Wilson went next door to ask his friend to play. But Dotty smiled. "I can't because I'm off to school today."
"Well, I'm not going," Wilson grumped. "Who wants to read and write? I'd rather play and watch TV and stay up late at night."
"Oh, you're so silly," Dotty smiled. "Come to school with me. There's nothing to be scared of. School's lots of fun. You'll see."
"Who says I'm scared?" growled Wilson. "A wolf is brave and strong. It's just the teacher might be cross if I get the answers wrong."
But Dotty wasn't worried. She just grabbed him by the paw. She marched him up the path to school and pushed him through the door. She hung his coat up on a peg. She made him use the loo, then took him to the classroom and showed him what to do. "First you paint a picture and stick it on the wall. Then you get some biscuit dough and roll it in a ball. You squeeze it and you squash it and you pat it nice and flat. Then get some biscuit cutters and make a shape like that. Next you get the ladybirds and count up all the spots. Then we'll draw a picture by joining up all these dots." At lunchtime they had pizza, then ran outside. "Let's play football," called a boy. "My favourite," Wilson cried. He ran and passed and dribbled. Then he scored a goal. Hooray! His team cheered, "Whiffy Wilson, you're the hero of the day."
"I thought no one would like me," said Wilson with a grin. "But look at all my lovely friends. It's great fun joining in."
In messy time that afternoon, they made a flying car. "What lovely work," the teacher smiled. "You've earned a golden star."
"This isn't work," gasped Wilson. "All we've done so far is play."
"Oh, you're so funny," Dotty laughed. "We've been working hard all day." But the day was nearly over, so they sat down on the rug. The teacher read a story and Wilson gave his friend a hug.
"This school is perfect," Wilson grinned. "It isn't dull at all. I can play with all the other kids. I can run and kick a ball."
"The classroom toys are really cool. The teacher is so kind. If I had to come here every day, I really wouldn't mind." Next morning, Whiffy Wilson was up and dressed at 8. He called for Dotty straight away. "It's school, we can't be late."
"Oh, Whiffy," Wilson Dotty smiled, "you really are the best. There's no school on Saturday. It's time to have a rest."
"But home is boring," Wilson whined. "I want to go and play. What can I do? Just stay inside and watch TV all day.
Never mind, smiled Dotty. You can come and play with me.
So they ran around the garden as happy as can be. The end. Let's have a quick look at the front and say thank you to the people that wrote this lovely, lovely book. I wonder who could be starting school even today at Summerswood who might be feeling the same way as Whiffy Wilson. Have a chat in your class about your earliest memories of Summerswood and what else you can be doing to be just as kind as Dotty was to Whiffy Wilson when he was feeling worried. I hope you enjoyed that story. I certainly did. And if you're wondering why I'm sparkling, I decided that there needed to be a sparkle because every time you read a book, it brings a little bit of sparkle into your life. I can't wait to hear about how many books you're going to read this week.